Hello. You're watching this because you've got some questions about the new top-level domain .tel. Don't worry, you're not alone in thinking this is yet another top-level domain, and why on earth do we need it? Well, with me in the studio today is Justin Haywood from Telnic, the company behind the .tel, who's going to take me through some of the reasons why Telnic thinks .tel is relevant to me and how it's been designed to simplify communications for businesses and their customers. So, without any further delay, let's get down to it. Justin, why on earth do we need another top-level domain? We've got .com, which everyone knows and uses, a whole load of other regional and bizarre ones, which people can't work out, and search engines to help us ignore all of them completely. Isn't this just another thing to oblige brand owners to buy this from you?
Wow, lots of tough questions there. Thanks, Adam. Well, the reason why people should be interested in .tel is that it's unlike any other top-level domain in existence today. .tel is about communications and not web content. It's about sharing contact information, not websites. So it's a service under the control of the owner.
Okay, so you say it's not about websites, but what does that mean?
It means that .tel uses the system behind the web to store contact information, enabling people to have a presence on the web without having a website.
Wait, how can you have a presence on the web without a website? And there's a system behind the web, I didn't know that.
Not a lot of people do, Adam, so you're not alone. Let me give you a quick historical overview. Basically, every time you type a domain name into an internet browser, such as IBM.com, you don't go straight to the website. Instead, your machine needs to first find where IBM.com is on the World Wide Web. So the domain name makes it easy for us humans to remember website names, but computers don't use them to connect with each other.
They don't?
No. They use long strings of numbers called IP addresses. And these IP addresses, effectively the locations of the websites I'm searching for, are stored in what's known as the DNS.
The system behind the web. So effectively, the DNS is the address book for the locations of the websites on the World Wide Web, but the IP addresses being the actual street address, as it were.
Exactly.
Okay, so what's different about .tel?
Well, instead of linking domain names with IP addresses stored in the DNS, .tel links domain names to contact information stored in the DNS. The difference is that when you type in a .tel domain in your browser, instead of downloading web pages, you're downloading very small amounts of data, all stored under a domain name. It's much quicker as you're cutting out a whole process of going onto the web and getting heavy web content back.
And why would people want that?
All of this effectively provides a new and cost-effective way of publishing and accessing up-to-date contact information, any type of contact information, quickly and cheaply, for any device connected to the internet without having to build a website.
So it's basically a 21st century contact directory.
That's part of the functionality, yes. It also overcomes the problems of fragmented yellow page services, which are costly, limited in the entries you can put in, and often contain out-of-date information that isn't helpful to people searching for them. So data is stored under your .tel, it's live, it's up-to-date, instantly accessible globally from any device simply by typing in your company name, .tel.
So Justin, what does .tel deliver?
Well, it means that people can publish information over the internet without being tied to any single service provider. It's their secure place in the cloud, and which they can manage and update with all types of contact information without having any real technological skill at all. And because the DNS is a global computer network, it's instantly published and accessible. With a .tel, you're accessing a mobile-optimized contacts directory with live data at very low cost because the data is very small. And it gets over the major frustration of the cost of access for downloading heavy websites.
So, Justin, I can store what? Telephone numbers? Email addresses? What else?
Here's my .tel page as it looks over a PC browser and a mobile browser. You can store any type of contact information you want. Email, mobile, links to websites, voice over IP numbers, customer relationship management solutions like Follow Me Anywhere numbers, even microblogging links or locations of islands in Second Life, or Xbox gaming handles, or your World of Warcraft nickname. And all of the data is click to connect. You click it, you get connected.
isn't it complex to put contact information in the DNS then? I mean, given that I've never heard of it before, won't it be difficult for me to use?
Here's the management console. It's a simple add, save, rearrange, delete process. There's no coding, no building of websites, and definitely no IT experts required. So this really needs to be thought of as a service, a publishing service and an information sharing service, rather than just another top-level domain.
All right, but as a business person, what does this give me?
Well, .tel has a significant amount of communications flexibility, but rather than talking about it, let's have a look.
Okay, so Justin, how might a large organisation use the .tel?
Well, this is one for businesses of all sizes to know and really shows the power and speed of the .tel. Here's what a .tel looks like from a number of different devices. This is large corporation, largeco.tel. This is live on the internet. Remember, this isn't a website that's been built. The information is just presented in a template. This is what it looks like over even a very small device. Here's the management console again. You've got contact information, multilingual keywords, and location records. You've got an unlimited number of subfolders, meaning you can structure information how you want.
Okay, so it's like a Yellow Pages listing, but with infinite space.
And under your control, which is the crucial part. Imagine you're a large organisation with products going out to an international audience, and the worst happens. There's something wrong with it, and they need to be recalled. Well, you have a legal obligation to provide as much information as possible to your customers, and you need to do it quickly and clearly.
Right.
So with a .tel, you can store an emergency number and links to further information about what you should do in this event, but you don't need to publish them.
So it's in the .tel, but not viewable?
Right. Immediately you need to activate that emergency procedure. All you do is enable the contact information, and here we're just going to disable the rest, and it will be live on the internet within a minute.
Wow, that looked simple.
Yes. And we can check it out over a mobile device.
I can see that already. So that, published in seconds, that's really powerful. So what else can you do with a .tel if you're a large business?
Well, here's something that I think everyone is going to like if they're a customer of a large business. We've all experienced these automated call centres where you spend ages waiting for the options.
Oh yeah, that really annoys me.
It's so frustrating, isn't it? You know, press 1 if you're a new customer, press 2 if you eat cheese, press 3 if you can touch your nose with your tongue.
Right.
Well, with the .tel, you can enable customers to click easily and quickly through those options, cutting down the time it takes to get them to talk to the right person.
And how does that work?
Well, remember those subfolders I was talking about? Well, you can use the structure of the .tel to help people navigate through complex tree structures, like automated call centres, so they can simply click through the options until they get the right contact information or department, and then pick up the phone.
Okay, Justin, prove it.
All right. Why don't you search for the Fitzrovia Hotel in London on this mobile, and let's see the first one to be able to get in touch with them.
Find the Fitzrovia Hotel. Okay. Ah, right. Fitzrovia Hotel. Here we go. Oh, no. That's a booking form, so it's not that one. Booking form. Grange Hotels. Grange.
And I'm there.
Okay. I can see how that makes the process a whole lot less painful. I think I'd like to talk to my bank about one of those. So, Justin, I'm in the broadcast media business. Is there anything that the .tel can do for my industry?
Well, I'm glad you asked that question. Yes, you've heard all about these reality television shows, Dancing with Stars, celebrities in jungles, would-be pop stars, where you have to vote each week for the contestants.
Yes, you can't really avoid them, can you?
Well, up until now, there's not been a simple way of managing competitions like this without outsourcing them. There's also a great deal of screen time spent walking people through all the ways in which they can vote.
That is true.
Well, using a .tel gets over a number of different problems. Firstly, you can put all types of contact information in there, whether they're premium rate telephone numbers, email addresses, SMS voting, or links to websites. So you can provide people with a choice of ways of voting very simply. Here's an example. We're voting for Jordan. Click, click. Click and we're there.
I see. So it's a simple way of getting people to remember program names instead of complex numbers.
Exactly. And anyone can manage it, and it's accessible from any device.
OK, Justin, this is all well and good if you know the .tel address that you're looking for, but how are people going to find a relevant .tel domain? Surely everyone is used to using search engines and established directory services, aren't they? They're not going to adopt something just because you want them to.
Well, you mentioned search engines, and the good news is that .tel is discoverable like any other domain. But because the .tel is structured information that's built for machines to understand and interact with, and because everything, the contact information, keywords, and location records, have labels that describe what they are, .tels will be indexed and understood by search engines.